Serbia looking to seal top spot by going 3-0 in Zrenjanin. Belgium looking for a win that would see them finish in pole position instead. Welcome along to Crystal Hall, where we started the day with a fascinating conundrum of permutations. The picture has since become a lot clearer. Both of these teams already through to the knockout stages. The winner in this one will seal top spot, which means direct passage to the quarterfinals. The loser here, along with Russia, will go to the quarterfinal qualifier round in a bid to make the final eight. Belarus now eliminated after their defeat earlier on this court against Russia. The 14-point margin means they cannot win a potential three-way tie and will finish in bottom spot. I'm Tim Long, alongside me is Great Britain men's assistant coach Lloyd Gardner. And Lloyd, this should be a fantastic game to finish. 2015 champion Serbia looking to remain undefeated and win the group. 2017 bronze medalist Belgium trying to get directly to the quarterfinals themselves.
Absolutely, Tim. These are the two best teams in my eyes. We may not have seen it last game out from Belgium, but they'll be looking for some redemption today. And this group, if it's told us anything, that it's to expect the unexpected. And that, you know, how important momentum can be in this game. Serbia come into this one, having ridden that momentum. Tough win on the first day, didn't play well, played much better second time out. Whereas Belgium started off on the high and now they've dipped down to a low. So how are the two teams who are going to respond from that? Will it be Belgium coming out playing the way they did on day one? Or will it be Serbia riding that momentum that they've got up until this point?
Yeah, Belgium controlled game one against Russia, pulling away with a 9-0 run down the stretch to win by 13, but they struggled in the fourth against Belarus, getting outscored 16-9 to lose the game by 8. And they've protected the ball well so far, 10 turnovers a game on average, but Messerman and Mestank haven't had enough help on offense. The rest of the team have shot just 25% from the field so far. Against Russia, it was 28% and they got away with it. Against Belarus, it was just 22% and they didn't.
The factor for me today when that shooting is, in the other games, they've had a massive advantage out on the perimeter. They play these small ball lineups and that gives them the head start. The problem is against Belgium, I'm not sure if it does. You know, Emma Messerman could come out and guard that perimeter without any problem at all. So the question for Serbia is, where is their advantage in this game?
Serbia beat Belarus in game one despite shooting just 25% from two-point range. 40% long-range shooting bailed them out in a game that had 22 lead changes and neither team up by more than 7. Sonja Petrovic with the game winner in the final 2 seconds. Then in game two, the two-point shot started to fall as well and they held Russia to just 29% from the field. The game was tied at the start of the fourth, but they won the final period 24-10 to win the game by that margin, 14-77-63. And the feeling there that things started to click into place for them.
Yeah, well, defensively, they got much better. And what they'll be looking at today is, can they force the Belgian guards to score? So my thing is, well, how are Serbia going to guard Emma Messman? Are they going to leave Jelena Brooks to guard her one-on-one? She's done a pretty good job in those matchups throughout this tournament, but Emma Messman's a different kind of animal.
Let's pause now for the two national anthems, starting with Belgium.
Serbia, please remain standing for the national anthem of Serbia.
Serbia.
It's the final game of Group D at Women's Eurobasket 2019. Top spot still to be decided here in Zrenjanin. Serbia and Belgium both battling to win the group and to go directly to the quarterfinals. Myself, Tim Long, alongside GB Men's assistant coach Lloyd Gardner to call the action here this evening. And whichever team can get their scorers warmed up and confident early will have a huge say tonight. Belgium have made less than 38% of their field goal attempts in both games so far. The first time that's happened for them in consecutive games at Eurobasket this century. And Serbia shot a torrid 30% on game day one, still escaped with a win. But on Friday, they heated up early and finished with 77 points, the most of any team in this group so far. Let's take a look at the full rosters. Emma Messerman has averaged a stunning 26 points, 9 rebounds, 1.5 steals and 1 block so far for Belgium. Kim Mesnak backed her up with double-figure scoring in both games, including 17 on Friday. Those two have lacked support on offense, though. But young point guard Julie Almon has become the first Belgian player this century to notch 5 or more assists in consecutive Eurobasket games. She's averaged 6.5 so far.
Absolutely, Tim. You know, you hit the nail on the head. Emma Messman, Kim Mestag, they've been absolutely brilliant. Question is, who else is going to step up from Belgium? Their perimeter play needs to shoot the ball better from the outside, and they need some inside scoring. Mestag, superb last game out. She was ice cold in the first game, and then smoking hot game two against Belarus with 17 points, 5 of 8 from 3. She was 5 of 6 at one stage. Question is, all them Serbian eyes are going to be on her, though. How is she going to free herself up to get her three-point shot away?
Sonja Petrovic led Serbia to victory with 18 points in game one before struggling in game two, but four of the players stepped up to score in double figures. Diana Butolia hit 3 of 4 from downtown en route to 15 points. Nikolina Milic had 14 off the bench on perfect shooting. Yelena Brooks had 12. And after a difficult game one, 2015 hero Ana Dabovic returned to form with team highs of 16 points, 7 rebounds and 6 assists.
It's almost a counterbalance to Belgium in that the role players from Serbia have been stepping up. But what Serbia are going to need to get deep into this tournament is Sonja Petrovic and Ana Dabovic both playing at the same time. Last game out, it was Ana Dabovic that stepped up. They're the incredible numbers from her in that big win against Russia. You know, Coach Malkovic has a lot of faith in Ana Dabovic, and essentially Serbia are going to go as far as she can take them. She takes a lot of responsibility in the offensive end, and she is real linchpin to this Serbian offense.
Another factor is the fouling. Serbia committed more fouls than any other team in the competition over the first two games. Will that continue against the Belgian side shooting a tournament fourth best, 78.3% from the foul line?
I think that a lot of those Serbian fouls are tactical, though. They know what they're doing. They commit fouls, they have mismatches because of the style of play, the way they have to guard the inside. So I don't think they'll worry too much. And what that does mean is that's why we've seen some of those other players, the role players, stepping up in times of need, because they do have this deep bench that they can use 1 through 12.
Led once again, as they were in 2015, by Marina Malkovic, who led them to the gold 4 years ago. Belgium led by Filip Mesdag, the father of two of his players, Kim Mesdag and Hannah Mesdag. Friday's defeat to Belarus saw Belgium's 8-game winning streak in the group phase of this competition come to an end. It's 16 years since they last lost 2 games at this stage. And this up-and-coming nation looking to pick itself up and go again to claim top spot. That would be a huge boost in their bid to upgrade on their first ever podium finish at a major tournament when they won bronze 2 years ago. But standing in their way, a Serbian side that's starting to find its flow. The 2015 champions, the only undefeated team in the group, and looking to go unbeaten for the first time ever at this stage. And of course, desperate to win gold on home soil in Belgrade next week. It is a fight for first to finish here in Zrenjanin.
I love looking at the way the teams line up, coming out of the coach's words, who's matching up with who, I expected it to be Jelena Brooks guarding Messerman, but it's not. It's Petrovic. You know, the threat of Linskins as well. And that's a tough matchup for Sonja Petrovic. More a traditional sort of three small forward, whereas Emma Messerman is a four, sometimes a five in a small lineup. So if they can get Messerman that much space on the low block, that's going to be a hard ask for Sonja Petrovic to guard her. And already less than 15 seconds in, first foul on Petrovic.
Messerman is now 11 of 12 from the foul line in the tournament as well. Efficiency personified. Petrovic for three, no. And a foul underneath. And Kim Mestak hurt as well.
Yes, something that's very important to Belgium there. Looks like she just kind of turned her ankle. She's doing her laces up, she'll be okay. And saying about the tough matchup on the other end of the full floor for Sonja Petrovic. For Belgium, that's going to be a tough one there, because the wings are big for Serbia, you know, Seven Dakic especially, and she'll look to post up against smaller players.
Double team on the far side and a foul.
Jump ball. Well, we criticised Belgium's lack of defensive effort against Belarus, especially in the first half. They gave a lot of confidence to Belarus. First possession here defensively for Belgium. They look locked in.
Ball inbounded off the baseline. Serbia searching for their first points and the first field goal of this one. The miss on the driving layup through the paint, though, from Petrovic. Kick back out, the cut in towards the basket. Will it go for Linskins? No. Battling away for the rebound, though, Kira Linskins, and score.
I think that's her first basket in the paint this tournament. You know, Linskins has been really poor at converting these chances, but you've got to credit the effort there for her to get after the first miss.
She was only one of seven from the field in game two. Now here comes Serbia. The head fake, the spin to the baseline, the score for Serban Dakic.
And that's the tough matchup. That's where Serbia do have an advantage, I think. Serban Dakic is more of a power forward playing that small forward spot.
Delar picks it back out to Linskins on the perimeter. Got away with one, Delar. Towards the edge of the paint. Now here comes Serbia. Crossover attack into the paint from Dabovic. Can't get it to go off the hop. Offensive rebound. Petrovic, though, in a fresh 14. And slow it down with Jovanovic. His 29th birthday today.
Yeah, Brooks has a mismatch here.
And the shot clock winding down as it's tipped away out of bounds. It will still be Serbian possession, but we've got half a second left. Dabovic has to put it up on the spin. It falls well short. Messerman underneath to try and lead the charge for Belgium. Linskins fires it back into Almon, the creator-in-chief. Messerman across to the far side.
With Delar, good defense in Serbia.
No way through for Belgium. Linskin shot clock down to four as she puts up the long ranger, and the long rebound off that for Mestag, who seems to be okay now after that twisted ankle. And a foul, which is the second on Serbia.
That's the way you've got to play Mestag, though. Don't let her shoot from the perimeter. Force her to put it on the floor. See if she can make a play off the dribble. I think Jovanovic will like that matchup. She loves that challenge where she gets to guard someone. And always puts in a good shift, Jovanovic, on the defensive end.
Julie Almon to inbound over on the far side, averaging 6.5 assists per game so far. Linskins hands it back to Almon, the 22-year-old point guard, who averaged 8 assists at the World Cup last year. Mestag scores on the occasion of her 100th cap.
That's a tough move. Said you've got to make her put it on the floor. Jovanovic did exactly that, but Mestak is too good on the pull-up.
Quick turnaround, jump shot, goes.
This is what we expected from these two teams, didn't it? Two high-level teams playing high-level basketball.
Almon driving through the paint, kicking it back out. Mestak misses her attempt from the outside after just hitting one from two-point range. It will remain Belgian ball, though.
I don't understand why people still continually rush at Julie Almon on the dribble penetration, especially leaving Kim Mestag open. You know, she's not going to miss many of those clean looks.
Mustad was 5 of 8 from the outside, as we saw in game 2. Delar, back to Messerman, the pump fake and the foul. So Serbia with 3 fouls in the first 3 and a bit minutes.
We talked about that before the game. I don't think they're that fussed by committing fouls. I think they use them pretty well. I think for Belgium, though, Messerman on that low block again. It's about the right time. See if you can draw a second on Petrovic. That would be key.
Messerman. Those 3 fouls for Serbia spread equally across 3 players. Almon to the corner. Delar will shoot the triple. She and the rebound out of it.
She has to start making that shot. If Belgium were a medal contender like we say they are, she needs to start making 3-point shots.
A trip to the line here for Serbia as they look to try and close the gap and get level at 6. Jelena Brooks. What a story it is, this tournament, for Jelena Brooks already. She missed the whole of the season on maternity leave. She joined the national team only 6 weeks after giving birth to get back in shape. Her baby and her husband are here with her. Serbia missing the second, but grabbing the offensive rebound. Kick to the outside, 3-point shot will fall, Serbia ahead.
You feel like she started to find that range in the last game out, hit a couple of real late threes.
Petrovic moving it on to Serban Dakic, swatted away. Now Belgium can run here. Julie Almon going through the gears. He can do so quickly. Serbia getting back quickly. In transition defence, Messerman still killing them though.
Yeah, Messerman, she's so efficient in and around the basket. I think, you know, that low post for her is the key today. She has all the versatility of stepping outside, but today is one of these games where she should just get down on the low block, go to work down there.
Dabovic moving it on to Brooks, and they'll go back to the line again.
You can see the problem Linskins is having guarding the speed of Serbia. And you see the substitution. Linskins has picked up the second, and it is Raman who comes in, who's a smaller big, so she can play next to Messerman. A lot better for her to be able to match up out on the perimeter, be able to try and take away some of these either one-on-one opportunities on the drive, or she can potentially can pick and pop.
Brooks only 1 of 6 from the field for 4 points in game 1. She fired 12 though in game 2. She's had a steal and a block in both games as well. Gets Serbia ahead here. Delar bounce pass. Messerman inside to finish. So Belgium up by 1, midway point of the first quarter. Messerman 6 points already. Petrovic. Serban Dakic looks in the mood, misses the shot. Petrovic trying to get underneath it, stepping on the line was Jana Raman. So this will be Serbian ball. Serban Dakic, young up-and-coming scorer for Serbia, who was worked her way into the player of the year position, given so many other key players have had absences from the national team. 23 years of age, she top scored in 3 of the 6 preparation games. He's only managed 4.5 points per game so far here, though 3 of 10 from the field before getting going early in this game. Serbia keep on getting to the foul line. This will be 6 free throw attempts in the opening 5 minutes and 21 seconds. Level at 10-10 off the miss. Almon so full of energy every time she comes down the floor. Again, Serbia getting back quickly though. Missed out. Can't shake off the attentions of Dabovic. Julie Almon. Interference run by Rama. Almon away to the far side. Difficult shot. But a foul though, as Messerman put it off the side of the backboard. She was nudged. Listen to the reaction from this Partizan crowd.
This is the advantage of it being in Serbia, isn't it? Serbian fans get the referee for every mistake.
Plenty of fouling in this first quarter. Belgium at the limit already. Serbia picking up 4. Still over 4 minutes to play. Messerman continues to fire. The second top scorer of all players in qualifying for this competition. She averaged 24.3 a game. Shot a competition third best, 66% from the field, including 44% from three-point range. It's 8 points of perfect shooting for her so far here. Brooks looking to axe her back, was long on the three. Serbia get another possession though. Dabovic, no look pass inside, flipped up and in by Milic.
Milic was an X factor yesterday when she came in. Some sort of impact here.
Mestad locked and loaded on the perimeter. Unable to hit. Here comes Serban Dakic in transition. Lurking on the baseline, waiting to finish was Jelena Brooks.
This is the Serbian tempo. This is what they want to play, fast, and a bit want the game to be up and down, lots of perimeter shots. Smart timeout from Filip Mestad, just to get a bit of control again. And it's only a two-point game, but you don't want to get your team to get carried away.
Serbia going up 14-12. Led by the 7 points of Brooks now. Spread the rest of their points around, but you look at Belgium and it's a similar story. 8 points for Messerman of their 12, very little help.
And it's really interesting that those two have almost matched up against each other. Messerman getting pulled into penetration, or she's getting pulled to help onto the ball, leaves Brooks open for the three-point shot. At the other end, it is Messerman down in the low post, going to work, pulling in and around the key.
Exactly what we were saying at the start, very early in this one of course, but over the first 6.5 minutes, Messerman's been superb. The rest of the team have shot 2 of 8 from the field.
Yeah, and that's the question for Belgium. We know Messerman, to be fair, we know that Kim Mestad will chip in as well. The percentage that Kim Mestad shoots, you can never guarantee, but she's always going to get, you know, that low double figure mark for you. But other people from Belgium, who's it going to be? Is it going to be Linskins finishing around the wing, or Wouters who's come in now? Is it going to be the guards hitting some shots like we said they probably need to do to be able to unlock this Serbian defence?
Belgium only down by 2 though.
A lot of changes now for Belgium. No Mestad, no Messman on the floor at all.
Rama moves it around to Dilar, who remains on the floor. Dilar towards the foul line and missed the shot. Dabovic fires it into the low post, an offensive foul against Nikolina Milic.
Got a good deep position, but just pushed off, trying to get the ball.
Mm-hmm. Both teams are at the foul limit for the first quarter already. The offensive foul, however, does not send the opposition to the line, only fouls from the defence.
And to show you how deep this Serbian team is, Milkovic comes in. She was superb on day one, played literally the entire second half, and didn't play yesterday. Oh, sorry, the last game two. And the same thing, Kutulija was unbelievable, arguably the player of the game for Serbia in their last victory, and she hasn't gone yet.
There's Vatlo for Belgium, crossover. And then down to her knees, was able to recover, no travel call. And the passing lane blocked off though by Serban Dakic. Serbia looking to turn up the heat. Here is Milkovic, the 31-year-old point guard. Serban Dakic wants to take on Dilar. It was a tough pass to play to the cutting Jovanović in traffic. Marpreo to Rama. Dilar looking for Reuters. Dilar takes it into the paint herself. Van Lo will shoot the three from the far side.
She hasn't got going, Van Lo, yet, has she? We expected her to be one of those shooters for Belgium, but still waiting for it to happen for her in this tournament.
Double figure scoring in several warm-up games, just 2.5 points per game so far here. Jovanović for three. Van Lo just 2 of 9 from the field at the tournament. Final 2 minutes of the first. Reuters, the 38-year-old veteran, as they're swinging around the perimeter now to Carpreo. Pass to the far side to Dilar, who's looking to drive in and attack aggressively, but can't find a finish again.
They're helping off Dilar to take away the inside, and she's going to have to find a way to be a scorer, whether it's knocking down that perimeter shot or on that slicing drive that she's usually really good at.
Offensive foul against Maja Skoric for Serbia as they turn it over, and neither team can score at the moment. Rana, Carpreo. There's a foul on the defence this time of Serbia, so this time it results in foul shots. Julie Van Lo at the line for two. She did have a team high 4.5 assists per game in qualifying, but Julie Almont has that playmaker role here.
Well, maybe some free throws can get Van Lo's stroke going from the outside. She only made 1 3 this tournament. You said the struggle from the field. And she was known as that stretch the floor, kind of backup combo guard for Belgium coming into this one. And Carpreo apologises to the bench. The Belgian's not happy with her for that. It's a silly foul, trying to press up the floor, commits a foul and just sends Milkovic to the line.
Belgium have been able to get back level. After Serbia looked like they were starting to build ahead of steam. Now Milkovic at the strike, makes them both. Approaching the final minute of the first quarter, Carpreo. Van Lo, back to Carpreo. Van Lo, again, Carpreo looking for something here. Van Lo also can be a creator. Crossover three-pointer this time, and she still can't get going. Milkovic, and swinging onto the corner. Step to the side, three, beautifully done. Defense up in the air, but no conversion. And then a foul.
It's a good jump ball.
Julie Almon comes back in to try and provide a creative spark for Belgium. Van Lo to the bench. So to Wouters, Messenen's back in as well. Final seconds of the first, Almo. Messenen, thought about the three, kept hold of it. Mestek, she will not think twice about it, but misses. And Milic comes up with a loose ball, looking to drive all the way to the hole. Milic wouldn't go down. And the foul underneath is called against Sasha Chacho.
Yeah, trying to get on the glass, went through the back of Kim Mestek. Right in front of the referee as well, so... Again, one of those fouls which is a little frustrating for your team because you just allow the other team to get two easy free throws.
The foul on the offensive rebound attempt counts as a defensive foul, so messed out to the line for two. Belgium looking to get back level again in this tight opening quarter. And you might get ahead, the offensive rebound, Messerman.
And hold for the final shot here. Oh no, bit of difference.
6 or 7 seconds differential. Almont looking to dance her way through the defense. That would have been a special finish. Final shot now for Serbia. Kutolia kicks it to the outside. Skoric has to put it up and didn't do so in time. The basket won't count. And that will do it for the first. Tight and well-contested game so far. Serbia with the edge, 16-15 over Belgium. It's been a fascinating 10 minutes so far at Crystal Hall in Zrenjanin between the two teams battling for top spot in Group D, Belgium and Serbia. Close every step of the way, Serbia up by just one at the end of the first. And this one absolutely has the potential of going the distance.
It's been a really entertaining first 10 minutes, hasn't it, Tim? You know, a couple of two boxers just jabbing. Right now, each other, we haven't really seen any team take hold of the game properly. We see Serbia potentially have that advantage with Elena Brooks out and out on the perimeter. We know Belgium have Emma Messman. We know if Emma Messman, you know, continues to have a big game like she did in that victory they had over Russia, then it really just makes everything easier for Belgium. But still, those questions are there for both teams, you know. How are Serbia going to guard Messman and are Belgium going to have enough scoring outside of her, especially from the three-point line, to be able to win this game?
And neither team has led by more than 4 points. The biggest scoring run has been 4 points, and we've had 6 lead changes over the first 10 minutes. Kutolia, in for the first time, back to Milic. Tries to swing it around the body of Raman, and wasn't quite on the same wavelength as her teammate on the perimeter.
A long time with this lineup, you know, Petrovic and Dabovic have both spent a lot of time on the bench, getting a good rest for the second half, perhaps.
Serbia with 5 turnovers, Belgium just 2. I mentioned before the opening tip that Belgium do protect the ball well. Helmut, a key part of the reason why, picks it back out. Messerman gets the defence in the air, steps inside and drains the long two.
And that's where you've just got to do a better job on the scout if you're Milic. She's turned and followed the ball, just been drawn towards the drive from Alamont, when actually she should just stay at home, know who she's guarding.
Kutolia was 3 of 4 from the outside yesterday, throws up an air ball today. Quarterback pass down the floor, and it's Hannah Mestak with the touchdown.
She was the one who challenged the shot and just leaked out afterwards.
Belgium have scored the first 4 points of the second quarter. There's the first foul of the quarter. Servan Dakic and Ana Dabovic set to come back in. So too, Yelena Brooks. Brooks finding Nikolina Milic, and she's called for a travel, so Serbia turn it over again.
Here comes Petrovic after her long break. They're nervous of her getting her second as well, because she's going to have to match up with Messman.
No Serbian players have a second foul just yet, but Belgium have Almon and Linskins on two. There is Julie Almon. Messerman calling for it, far side, up against Petrovic now. Hannah Mester. Passes to her sister, on it goes to Wouters. Wouters faking the pass, instead turning to the baseline, missing the shot, rebound Servan Dakic.
Brooks again, one-on-one coverage against somebody much bigger. It's a really good job always in that low post.
Dabovic. Utolia. Looking to attack Kim Mester. Blazes past her, swatted away though by Messerman. Yelena Brooks will try. She misses. And batted forward towards Messerman, but straight through to Dabovic. Crazy passage of play here that ends with an offensive foul.
In their stag, it's pulled two calls, nearly got a third from the officials. Just put her body on the line. Good play from her, good smarts. Second on Dabovic.
The first Serbian player to pick up her second, that was the rejection to stop Butolia.
A different lineup here for Belgium. They've got Delar at the point. Seen that at all this tournament. The two Mestak sisters outside her. What a shooting on the wing. There's one of them.
And a Mestak way off the mark. You could tell as soon as it left her hands. Not played too much. And a Mestak hitted a three-pointer off two attempts from the outside in game two. Dabovic. Batted back, big effort on the boards by Petrovic. They'll go again, Serbia, driving through, left-hand layup, Walter's got a piece of it, the 38-year-old. They have to dig deep on defence again. Sonja Petrovic puts it up, contested, and banks it in at the buzzer. Well, the hero, wasn't she here on night one, doing it again here. And Belgium quickly down the floor to punish Serbia.
Making Serbia work for every point though. And this was what I was saying about the, you know, the perimeter attack of Serbia. Do they have an advantage? I'm not sure they do, because Messman playing some good D on Petrovic and Wouters as well against Brooks. This is now a crucial matchup here. Hannah Mestak trying to guard the low post.
Petrovic puts it on the floor. It slips away from Brooks. She's going to have to heave it up from near centre court here. And that's a shot clock violation.
It's like an inverted offence from Serbia. They're posting the perimeter players and playing the interior players outside. So, you know, it creates some different matchups. But Belgium have done a really good job there. Now they've changed their lineup, so it'll be even harder for them to guard the inside now, especially Servan Dakic.
Serbia have only scored 2 points in this quarter. Belgium up by three, Almon, or Batlo rather. Wouters turns it over, and here comes Serbia on the charge here with Jovanović to the far side. It's going to be a long two. If it goes, it's another air ball. A trap on the baseline, can she find her way out? Delar, she draws the contact.
Must be a breeze in the gym, none of air balls we've seen. Nothing struggling.
Just listen to this crowd here in Zrenjanin, Serbia, right behind the hosts.
They've warned Malkovic as well for a technical. I mean, you can't look at that and say she didn't get fouled. clear contact.
Dillard fires it in to Wouters. That's a gift of a basket for her. Lovely pass into the interior, but she was left alone. Belgium have the largest lead of the night so far. Timeout called by Coach Malkovic.
Belgium, that's just a really good spell for them. Start this second quarter defensively, even though they have, you know, the couple of baskets they've conceded have just been really good defensive plays. So, yeah, the other team scored, but you did everything you could at that moment. You're not going to hold them scoreless. Throughout the game, you just have to play the percentages, and I think that's exactly what they've done. They've forced them to the shots that they want, and some have gone, but a lot more haven't. And then offensively, they've been pretty comfortable. Scored in transition, they're moving the ball a bit better. If they can just hit some three-point shots as well, that's going to open up even more for them.
You saw the offensive rebound count there. Serbia with double the offensive boards of Belgium at 8-4, but they've also turned the ball over 8 times. Belgium protecting it ever so well, just 3 turnovers in the opening 14 minutes of play. The first quarter of this one was watertight, never separated by more than 4 points, by only 1 at the end of the first 10 minutes, but Belgium have so far won the second quarter 8-2. And their fans certainly enjoying the occasion. So many smiles on the faces of those in Serbian colours here in Zrenjanin just yet. Brooks. A foul away from the ball handler. 2 on each team now here in the second. It's 2 on Vanlo. Slogan Blackic to inbound. Brooks. Milkovic. Slogan Blackic across to the far side up against Delar. Brooks goes across. She crosses over. Looks to spin on the foul line. Nice pass to Skoric, who backs it in.
It was a really good defensive sequence until the last 2 seconds, where Ramon just lost her man on a back cut. Apart from that, they were pretty comfortable right there. Good play from Skoric for the score, though. Smart cut.
Down low to Ratman. Couldn't help shoot the 3, but she misses, and Serban Dakic the rebound, looking to run here, the length of the floor. Forced away by Mestak, back out, and they'll slow it down and play in the half court. Milkovic runs for the screen, crossover onto the left, goes through the gears and runs into a huge defensive wall in the shape of Jana Ratman. Wouters hands it back to Vanlo to the far side. Kim Mestak for 3. Got it. Belgium up by 6.
Criminal defense from Serbia. Pick and roll, far side. You can't help off into the middle and leave Kim Mestak open like that. Now she's got a range as well.
8 points for Mestak. Largest lead so far. The floater will fall in response for Serbia, though.
And then he took another charge in as well. Didn't quite get outside of the line on the floor. I think that's why she didn't get the call. It's a good finish from Jovanović.
Vanlo. Wouters. Swinging around to Vanlo. Delar, high entry pass. Wouters did well to reel it in, but wasn't able to release against the backboard from that position. Milkovic moves it on. Brooks looking to battle her way to the ball. Tipped away by Ramon, who's coming up big defensively. Dillard released on the fast break, and she puts it in.
She made it hard. I thought she had the right-handed layup. She's quick and such a good athlete. Decided to come back to the middle. Must have made it a harder finish for herself, but got it to go.
The first score for Dillard on her 5th attempt from the field. 11-3 on the fast break to Belgium. There's a foul as Milkovic attacks at the other end.
She's been good again, Milkovic, I think.
She provides a lot of energy.
Yeah, it really does. Both ends of the floor. She's a little two-way player. Some of the other Serbian guards, perhaps not the same way as that.
So 6 points, the Belgian lead. Vanlo picks up her 3rd foul and goes to the bench. Milkovic goes to the line. And Serbian fans here desperate to see their team win and go 3-0 and have a direct passage to the quarterfinals. Of course, if they lose, the home fans have got one more game to watch, potentially, but it's valuable to have that extra day's rest as well, and no guarantees of getting through that quarterfinal qualifier. Carpreo. Rana receiving it from Nolars. Drive to the baseline, a kick back out. Nolars moves it on. Lovely ball movement. Raman's three-point shot short. Messerman offensive rebound. Lovely cut from Delar. The pass from Messerman and the flip finish.
Delar has started to contribute scoring-wise. Such a big addition to this Belgian team. So the other teams have been really playing off her, giving her the perimeter shot.
Ivanovic across to the near side. Scorch. Nice pass thread in the eye of the needle. The miss, though, from Milic.
Again, just first-class rotation from Belgium. Even though they gave up the shot, just everything on point for them, still to be able to challenge the shot.
Carpreo, Messerman, swing it around the perimeter again. Carpreo, shot clock down to five, into Messerman, who's fouled straight away.
The second quarter has just been a real clinic from Belgium, in my eyes. 15-7 it is, and both ends of the floor have been really, really good.
Second foul on Milic, 13th foul on Serbia. 2.5 left to play in the quarter. Messerman looking for the handoff. Carpreo with 8 seconds to work with, and it goes to Messerman in the painted game. Found Delar, three in the corner. Can she hit from the outside now? No. Popped away from behind the pickpocket, and here comes Messerman off the window. Emma Messerman still hasn't missed. 12 points on perfect shooting, but here's Jovanovic to reply. No, and a foul underneath. Son Delon, the fourth on Belgium.
Smart foul again from Belgium. You got one more to give. I'm sorry, that was the foul to give. He used it because they were their players still trying to recover after Messerman was knocked to the floor.
Jovanovic trying to take on Carpreo, and there's the fifth foul. So Nevena Jovanovic will go to the line.
Again, with, you know, it's her second time. She's been so aggressive in trying to steal the ball, fouled when she probably didn't need to.
Ivanovic has been a key contributor, had 9 points, 5 rebounds, 3 steals and a block in game one, and then 6 points, 7 boards and 2 steals in game two.
She's the 3-and-D type of player, you know, real defensive effort all the time, and then knocks down that open three as well.
Carpreo, they get over centre court despite the press. Rana to Messerman. She's going to line up a long two this time, and it falls short, her first miss of the game. A minute and a half remaining here in the first half. The lead is 8 for Belgium. Lovely move spinning in to score from Nikolina Milic, who's been so efficient over these last 2 games.
A really good move. She does an excellent job. She's the best, I would say, in this group that we've seen, running down the floor, getting to the front of the ring as that first big and establishing position that they can just immediately pass to you and you get a quick finish. Not much to it, no dribble, just catches and finishes, but it's all because of the way she runs the floor and gets that position early on.
Milic has 4 points off 2 of 4 shooting here, but in the last game on Friday, she was a perfect 6 of 6 from the field for 14 points. Now you see the turnovers, 9 for Serbia, just 3 for Belgium. The Belgium lead is only 6, though. And the offensive rebound counters gone some way to making up for those turnovers. 9 for Serbia, 5 for Belgium.
Fouls have really hurt Serbia, with Petrovic and Dabovic on the bench. It's an interesting difference, isn't it, in the other games that we've seen where coaches have really you know, put a lot of faith in their players to play them with foul trouble. And here, two fouls only for Petrovic and Dabovic. Neither of them have played. They're not coming back. I don't know whether it's because, obviously, both these teams have qualified. Maybe Malkovic wants other players to have this responsibility today.
Andre Carfrea. Belgium up by six off the back of the timeout. Kim Mestak, as they try and extend the lead here, approaching the final minute of the first half. Shot clock to five. Carfrea. Lightning fast crossover, then lost it on the dribble. Big chance in transition here for Serbia, but Carfrea did well to get back. Milkovic has to slow it down. Jovanović. Slovan Dakic. Backs out, shot clock to four. She takes the contested three. It's too long. The rebound grab by Carfrea. Both teams really struggling from the outside. Just two of 19 combined. Mesta. Messerman fires it in, the cut down the baseline, the step into the paint, and the score again on the interior from Delar.
And everyone said, you know, the Belgium of 2017, 2018, they moved the ball, they moved themselves so beautifully. And we haven't really seen it, I would say, in these first couple of games, but today we have. Great movement off the ball from them.
Brooks for three, won't go down. Offensive rebound, Milic, can she get it away? There's a foul, and it's going to be two free throws for Nikolina Milic as the game clock expires.
I think they're going to check, they can check the monitor to see whether the foul came before, and I've got a feeling it did. The buzzer went off first. I'm notoriously bad at seeing these, but I felt like the foul was after.
Here. Okay.
Certainly seemed like the release was after.
Yeah.
Go. In front,
but now, go, here. And Serbia down by eight. This is a big call.
Look, there is time inside.
There's a foul there, but the clock has expired.
Yeah. The call was a foul. So unless they can see evidence that that's the wrong call, it will stay a foul. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to tell, to be honest.
Can't tell it.
Yeah.
That's it. Belgium celebrate. No foul shots for Serbia. This partisan crowd wild up again. Their team have to fight back in the second half from an 8-point deficit. Belgium 34, Serbia 26 at the end of two.
I've just been so impressed with this Belgian first half performance. After the criticism that I gave to them in the loss against Belarus, they just didn't look like they were ready to play. I mean, they have been absolutely superb here today, both ends of the floor, defensively, position, effort, execution has been really, really impressive.
And that despite shooting 1 of 11 from downtown, they've been dominant on the interior, 57% efficient from the line as well, and limited Serbia's percentages. 10 offensive rebounds for Serbia, double the tally of Belgium, but the turnovers have bridged that gap. Serbia turning the ball over 9 times in the half, and Belgium only 4 times, ever so efficient, led by the 12 points of Messerman. Mestak has chipped in with 8, Delar's got going with 6, and nobody for Serbia on more than 6 points.
So Emma goes with this.
Popovic really feeling it here. Moves it on to Brooks, who started to feel it as well.
On Stokes, now the pass up ahead, and great running by Slovenia.
Still chance to throw it up here for Bentley.
Oh!
Alex Bentley beating the buzzer at the half, and Belarus, what a backlash from them. After shoot, it's Messerman for three, gets Belgium back in business to beat the buzzer.
A little simple, little sucker punch, but when you've got endurance and athleticism.
Welcome back to Crystal Hall here in Zrenjanin, Serbia, where Belgium pulled away in that second quarter, a 19-10 second quarter in their favour, and they lead by 8 at the half against Serbia in a battle for top spot in Group D, 34-26. In favour of Belgium, and at the moment they're going directly into the quarter-finals. It would mean Serbia had to play in a quarter-final qualifier in the capital in a couple of days' time. There's still plenty of time left, of course, for plenty more twists and turns over the next 20 minutes of this one, but Belgium led by the 12 points of Emma Messerman, 4 of 5 from the field and 4 of 4 from the line as well. She's got help today with 8 points from Mečnjak and 6 from Dilar, who stepped up in that second quarter. Serbia, nobody on more than the 7 points for them of Jelena Brooks, have really struggled on offense again after we thought they'd got going yesterday when they scored 77 points, just 26 in the half today, Lloyd.
Yeah, well, the biggest thing, Tim, is the fact that Sonja Petrovic and Ana Debovic have combined for 2 points between them. Messman has done what she did, and we wondered how they were going to guard her, and I don't think they've found the answer yet. Said 12 points, she's been very good indeed, but the Belgium defence has been the key to it, really. Petrovic and Debovic had to go to the bench because of foul trouble, and after that, Belgium just, you know, were clinical on the defensive end. In terms of one-on-one coverage, in terms of rotation, understanding, scout, everything you would look for was really, really good. Now, the only little chink, perhaps, was that Jelena Brooks 7 points early, and she relies on the threat of the others. So Petrovic and Dapovic being on the floor frees it up for Brooks. So when they go out, that helped Belgium contain her a little bit as well.
Yeah, Brooks only finished 2 of 8 from the field for those 7 points to lead Serbia in scoring. Nevena Jovanovic has 6, nobody else more than 4. Surely at the start of this second half we'll see Davovic and Petrovic again, not picking up those third fouls, not allowed to pick up those third fouls, but as you say, it could be a case of the coach trying to get minutes to the whole extent of the roster. How much would they worry about going to that quarterfinal qualifier? Will it bother Serbia or not?
I think they would ideally like to miss it, but it's the bigger picture of it. Obviously, we talked about the fact that Serbia didn't play any of the qualifiers. You know, they came into this with the same warm-up as everyone else, but an extra game, maybe that would help them a little, especially with players like Jelena Brooks, who haven't played all year. But I think that the second half will be different as well. You know, she's held them back to be able to use them in the second half. So while it's been good minutes for everybody, the lead is still such that Serbia have no problem in getting back into this game should they play better, and that's got to be the key.
Some of those quarterfinal qualifier games are played tomorrow in Belgrade, but for whichever team needs to play in it from this game, it will be on Tuesday. There's a travel day tomorrow, and then they will be ready to move into the quarterfinals, which take place on Thursday. The semi-finals on Saturday and the medal matches on Sunday. All of those knockout stage games taking place in Belgrade, which is about an hour south of here. We're in Zrenjanin and we have one half remaining in Group D. Serbia looking for a big comeback against Belgium, who've led by as many as 9 points and they're up by 8 at the half. And what a recovery from Belgium as well after starting well and then suffering their first defeat. Now they could become the first team to beat the hosts and take top spot in the group. Belgium, a set of players who've been playing together for a long time and started winning medals a decade or so ago back in the youth competitions. They are the youngest team in this group, an average age of 26. They won bronze, their first medal at any major tournament in this competition 2 years ago. And there's very much the feeling that Belgian basketball is in the ascendancy, and they're absolutely targeting a silver or even a gold here in Serbia this year. So too, of course, are the hosts, who won one under Coach Malkovic 4 years ago. We have the sixth man of this crowd behind them, and will do as well when they go to Belgrade, of course. And it's a team that are trying to put the pieces of the puzzle together gradually after plenty of disruption over the course of the last year. Jelena Brooks on maternity leave, Anna Dabovic taking large parts of the season off, Sonja Petrovic with some injury concerns. And Servan Dakic emerging as a key player for the national side as well. They're down by eight at the start of the second half here. Quick give and go. Dilart giving it to Linskins and then tipped away as it went into Messerman, who's adamant that should be Belgian ball.
That's not going to please the crowd at all. But Messerman complained and he changed his call. I think the referee just pointed in the wrong direction, that's all it was. But it's plays like that the crowd don't like.
And on to inbound to Messerman. And one again. Linskins causing some disruption on the perimeter and then cuts into the paint, gets a one-on-one opportunity, wouldn't fall for it, backs back the rebound though, and Almon will finish.
Keeps saying, I'm going to need Linskins to finish some of these opportunities around the basket.
Chacho has not played much at all today. Petrovic, who does start the second half, as does Dabovic, those two players who sat on two fouls towards the end of the first half. Over the head pass from Dabovic, Petrovic knocks it down.
And they've got a lot of energy left in those legs. And they sat for so long in that first half.
Linskins intercepted by Petrovic, doing it on offense and defense. Looking to drive coast to coast as well, providing the Serbian spark, Sonja Petrovic.
Belgium just need to take some heat out of this game here. And slow it down a second, take the crowd out of it. Their score.
6 points for Petrovic, four of them have come in the last few seconds. Mustak to Almon. Messerman wants it, it goes the other way to Linskins and she misses.
Really good offense still though. And good shot, that's Linskins' kind of range, that one.
Serbia were down by 10 on that first score of the third quarter. Now they're looking to score three times without reply to close the gap down to four or three. Shot clock to five. Dabovic crosses over, attacks down the lane, gets contact and pops it in with the foul from Messerman.
Such a good finish from Anna Dabovic. That's her little go-to, putting it in one hand, holding it right out in front of her where the defense can't block it. A good finish from Anna Dabovic, and it was the free throw line that got her going yesterday. So today gets there, although it's in the second half, not the first. When she can get to the line, she just seems to give her that confidence. Everything flows from that moment forwards.
She'd missed her first three field goals today and picked up the two fouls as well, and then she converts that and gets the and one as well. And it's 7 points without reply for Serbia.
Belgium make the sub, going to this smaller lineup again. Linskins goes out. It might not be the game for her today.
Dilart to inbound. Almon taking the ring road around the defense. Looks back out to Dilart, who saves it from being a backcourt. Left hand trying to foot one up. And Brooks is in the way, but picking up the pieces to score yet again is Messerman.
Messerman is just always where you need her. Whatever you want, she seems to provide.
Puts the ball on the floor, Brooks into the lane, skips through a gap, dazzling the defense but missing the layup. A crazy passage of play. Petrovic turns it on. Dabovic with another talismanic attack.
That was poor from Belgium. They got too carried away with the transition opportunity. They need to control this crowd, control the game.
Belgium only had four turnovers in the first half. They've had two in the first 3 minutes of the second. Nassiman turns around, looks at the rim and puts it in the net.
That's much better. Her size just means she can shoot over Yelena Brooks. Brooks can't really challenge or block the shot. Nassiman knows that.
16 ultra-efficient points from her. Chacho. Petrovic receives it in the high post and looks to go one-on-one with Delar. Crosses over into the lane, lost to Fetting. And now it's a three-on-two opportunity for Belgium here. Almon to Messerman, who misses the layup. Only her second miss of the entire game.
And probably her easiest shot as well. Another really good defensive possession from Belgium. An excellent one-on-one defense from Delar. Messerman will be frustrated with that one.
And puts her 6 of 8 from the field and 4 of 4 from the line for those 16 points. Look at the burst to the basket, slicing right through the defence with Nevena Jovanovic.
You said she's a 3 and D type. That was perhaps a little unfair as the pressure coming.
Well, Belgium have had 3 turnovers already in the third quarter after just 4 in the whole of the first half.
This is the way they want to play Serbia. They want to make it scrappy. They want to press and trap and run and have the crowd on their side. And they've got it here. They didn't ever get to that point in that first half.
Home fans raising the volume as well. 3-point shot. Might have taken the roof off this arena had it tied the game from 10 down for Serbia. A foul on Čačo as Almon burst down the floor. Her second, and Serbia's second of the quarter. Messerman moves on to the corner. Ramat dishes it off, baseline to La. Beautiful, pretty reverse.
Yeah, just great interplay again, unselfish from Belgium. Once they find that advantage, that little head start, they're really good at moving the ball and continuing to play until they get a great shot.
Petrovic was fouled. Belgium back up by 5, looking to hold off the comeback attempt of Serbia.
Yeah.
And we're going to have a look at the video here.
Just to see if she held her shirt.
She grabbed him. Okay.
Petrovic getting away from Raman.
The question is whether Raman with the left hand pulled on the shirt. I don't think she did.
An unsportsmanlike foul would give Serbia free throws and possession.
There is no confusion. We'll stay with normal foul.
Okay. Yeah, this is.
It just looks like her hand was on the small of her back.
42.
The foul on Raman, non-shooting, so the inbound from the far side to Dabovic. Brooks running interference as Dabovic then backs off and looks to attack again. 3-point shot, won't go down, rebound grabbed by Raman. Raman running into trouble as she tried to get over centre court. Petrovic just about able to grab the handle on the ball. Dabovic takes on the long two, misses it, pushed back off the window, batted back and into the hands of Messerman.
Belgium have got to recognise when they can run and get those really easy transition scores and when to slow it down a bit.
Messerman was fouled as soon as it went into her. It's 3 on Serbia here, just over the midway point of the third. Nobody has more than two personal fouls, though. And Messerman turns it over. That's as many turnovers from Belgium in the first 5 minutes and change of the second half as they had. In fact, more. It's five now in the second half versus four in the whole of the first half.
The whole game in the first half was of such high quality. The second half has been really scrappy.
Chacha, shot clock winding down to the final few seconds. Dabovic, is she aware? No, she wasn't. At least not precisely. Didn't get it away in time. It's a shot clock violation and a turnover from Serbia. Struggling to get the ball in, goes eventually to Messerman. Here's Kim Mestak for three. No, those points have dried up for her. Dabovic looking to attack straight away. Difficult finish, caught under the hoop. Offensive rebound, Petrovic. She misses as well. Dabovic, third time lucky perhaps for Serbia. Serbian fans getting right behind their team here, and a foul, which will be Belgium's third of the quarter as well.
Work on the glass from Serbia. Petrovic playing out of position, doing a really good job.
Jovanovic coming out. There's Chacha, and Petrovic firing it in to Brooks. Shot clock down to the final 2 seconds. Brooks off the window, wouldn't go. Another offensive rebound and a whistle.
Sonny Petrovic is just killing them on the glass at this moment in time. Galar doing all she could to hold on to her. But she had the arms wrapped behind her, went back. Just tying up Sonny Petrovic, that's where the foul was called.
Serbia were grabbing all of these offensive rebounds in the first half as well, but the differential in the turnover count was balancing that out. Now Belgium are turning the ball over at will, and Serbia are still grabbing the offensive rebounds and getting these second and third chance and even fourth chance opportunities. Turned over into the hands of Mestak, though. That was their 15th offensive rebound of the game.
To the monitor again.
It's going to be four fouls on both teams in the quarter with 3.5 minutes to play. Third foul on Dabovic. She's the first Serbian to pick up a third.
No sign of her coming out from the bench, though.
Belgium up by five. They're led by eight at the start of this half. Still their ball on the far side as Serbia try and battle to win it back. Milkovic will come in again for Serbia. And Dabovic does go to the bench on those three fouls. Mestan. Still Belgian ball. Last touch called off Chacha. Julie Almond gets it into Delap. Under the hoop, goes for the reverse. Delightful from Delar.
Yeah, she played really well, Delar. Started off poorly, missed a lot of opportunities, but now, as we were asking for, she's found a way to score into those reverses.
Milkovic for three, misses. Another offensive rebound and a foul on Wouters. But for all of the promise from Serbia here in the third, They've still only got 1 point back as it stands on the half-time differential.
Good point. The Belgium, they need to clean up. That's what they'll be frustrated with. They'll think these are issues caused by their lack of execution. You know, their ability not to box out and rebound is controllable by them.
Some fearing the worst. Ivana Stankovic makes the second, closes the gap to six. Just cleaning up the court here before Raman inbounds again. Just a reminder that top spot in the group is on the line and a safe passage through to the quarterfinals without having to play in the extra round, the quarterfinal qualifier. Almond turning on the afterburners and losing it on the dribble and kicking it out of bounds.
I was just thinking she's so good against pressure, Almond, literally the moment she kicked it off her foot. So she's a tough guard, she's really quick with the ball. So difficult to trap and press.
Chacho making a move out to the perimeter to receive it from Milkovic. Turned it on towards Stankovic, who got fouled by Wouters. Belgium at the limit, so Dragana Stankovic will go to the line. A 24-year-old centre who had a really useful 7 points, three rebounds, including two on the offensive glass and a steal in game one. Only played 3.5 minutes in game two. Serbia back within four. Vanlo. Rano. Norman on the move to receive it. On the far side. Wouters. The veteran. Far side. Back to Almond. Shot clock ticking down on her. Contested by Chacho. Onto the baseline. And there's a foul.
I think it just bounced on the line, so it's going to go back to Belgium. Last touch off Serbia. Really good job from Raman. She was the only person in there from Belgium. Three Serbians around the ball, but I couldn't secure it. Both teams having problems just looking after their defensive glass.
Wouters trapped in the far corner, can she find her way out? Uses her experience and her quality and her strength to do so. Shot clock down to the final four. Van Loo crosses over, steps back behind the three-point line and misses it by some distance. Great one-on-one defense on that outside shot.
Yeah, Van Loo probably made the wrong decision. She thought she was going to get the defender on the heels, have the open three, but possibly could have just turned the corner, got to the ring. Easy in hindsight, though.
Look at that, 2 of 27. Combined from the outside, these two teams here today. Then two for Serbia, that one off the mark as well. Wouters tips it into the hands of Mestad, and they can look to try and hold off this Serbian comeback and create a bit of a breathing room heading towards the fourth. Messinen into Wouters. Tried to turn it back to Messinen, no way through. Milkovic threading the three, stepped inside, kicked it back out. Three-point shot, short for Jovanović, and the struggles from the outside continue. Almond, quick release, down the floor to Vanlo, who puts it in.
Those two are so quick, Vanlo and Almond. Almond got the rebound, and Vanlo had already taken off, not catching her if she's got a head start.
The lead is six for Belgium again. A minute and change remaining in the third. Messerman guarding Petrovic. The bounce pass down the baseline, only just recovered, but what a cut down the lane from Milkovic.
Not sure where the defense was. Still on the rotation.
Come on, bursting to the basket, denied by Stankovic, coming up big at both ends of the floor.
defence. Alamo was going to be able to beat her with that little burst of speed, but recovery. Excellent.
It was Stankovic's bounce pass to find the cutter to the basket on the previous Serbian score. And then she comes up with the rejection on the defensive end as well. Still Belgian ball though. Linskins across to this near side. DeLong moves it on quickly. Messerman pivoting and missing. Stankovic with a rebound too. Butolia. 10-second differential between shot and game clock at the end of the third. Serbia from 10 down, looking to make it a one-possession game. Three-point shot, Servan Dakic won't go down. And it's hard to explain the struggle from the outside for both teams. Serbia are now 1-15.
It's incredible, isn't it? We come into this one, you know, talking about the three-point threats of both teams. Serbia won the game on the first day with their three-point shooting. Belgium historically have had great shooters. Kim Mestak was, what, 5-for-6 at one stage in their last game, and between them, they've been able to throw the penny in the ocean.
Cool under pressure at the line is Kira Linskins for Belgium. 15.2 seconds remaining for Serbia to advance the ball and create something. They're down by 6 again. Butolia will inbound. Plenty of time to work with. Petrovic got a free look for 3 and another miss from the outside. Mestak recovered the ball in the corner and then lost it.
Couldn't quite pull it in, could she? It's a great move from Petrovic, just completely lost Messman on a screen.
She's 0 of 3 from three-point range, Petrovic. They put up the long 2 to try and beat the buzzer and can't. And Serbia finished the third on a drought. And they were only able to close that half-time gap by a couple of points. Belgium still have a 6-point safety net in the fight for first. Belgium 48, Serbia 42. Welcome back to Crystal Hall in Zrenjanin in Serbia. We're ready for the start of the final quarter of Group D, and there's still so much to play for. Top spot set in the sights of Belgium and Serbia, but Belgium will start the fourth with a 6-point edge. They led by as many as 10 right at the start of the last quarter before Serbia turned it around, and it looked as though they would complete the comeback. But Belgium figured out a way of holding the Serbs at arm's length, despite the intervention of Ana Dabovic, who came to the fore. Messerman continues to score for Belgium and leads the way of all scorers in the game with 16 points.
Well, the Belgians are really good in the first half. I don't think they played quite as well in that third quarter. But credit to Serbia, they came out with the energy that set a bit of a gauntlet down to the Belgian team. See if they can do the same again here at the start of this fourth. You know, they've got this lineup they like on the floor with Dabovic and Petrovic together. I'm surprised Brooks hasn't come back out as well, but they just need some rhythm offensively. Serbia, they want to get on a run, 6 points, something like that, that'll really help.
Oh, Stankovic, Linskin stuck to her like glue and swatted it away. What a play to set the tone for the fourth from Belgium. Messerman to the far side. Van Loo for three. Wouldn't go down. Dabovic the rebound. Right.
Another great look, but another miss.
Dabovic, lovely footwork to escape the attentions of Messerman, and she got it to go.
Seven for Dabovic. She's going to try and take over this game now. It's going to be a key matchup.
She was only 2 of 8 from the field before that. She comes up with a steal as well and has the freedom of Crystal Hall to finish. Serbia turning up the intensity again. Belgium call on Julie Almond to try and keep Serbia at bay. The hosts are back within two. Almond. Petrovic did just pick up her third foul. Messerman. And Mestad got it. A big time three for Belgium.
Yeah, keep running that same play. Messerman on the low post. And with Linskins out there as well, there's a lot of shooters. So you can't come and double because that's what happens. And if you play Emma Messerman one-on-one, we know what she's capable of doing.
And Serbia responds. Butolia. Tipped away as it went into Stankovic. The turnover from Serbia. Elmo. Belgium were just 1 of 15 from three-point range before that one from Kim Mestad. Linskins. Elmont spots a gap. Instead played it out to Delar, who steps into mid-range and hits. Delar has 12 points.
That's the difference between the first quarter and the fourth. Because that same spot, that same play, the help off Delar. She took three of those pull-ups, missed them all. And this one, though, you see a little fist pump after the confidence of making all those finishes around the ring now. She knocks that one down as well. It's a big basket for Belgium.
6 of 12 from the field for 12 points, 3 in double figures for Belgium. After Mestak's 3, she's up to 11. Messerman leads the way with 16. And they've added that third scorer here today when Messerman and Mestak were carrying the fight in games 1 and 2. Serbia with 8 extra offensive rebounds. I mean, Serbia have taken 4 extra shots in the game, but Belgium are shooting at a greater efficiency. 56% on the inside, knocking down that second three-pointer as well. Serbia just 41% inside and only 1 of 15 from three-point range themselves. Somebody had to get going and get one from the outside, and you could probably put your money on Kim Mestad. 5 of 8 from the outside yesterday, or on Friday rather.
And how will Serbia respond coming out of the timeout? Dabovic will be involved here, I reckon.
Belgium by 7. Jovanovic. Petrovic, the hero late on in game one, kicks it back. Jovanovic for 3, and you wait so long, and then 2 come along at once.
That's a big shot for Serbia because they were doubling onto Petrovic without fear of Serbia knocking down the 3. Now they've made one, you can't help quite as easily onto the low post. Same thing here with Messerman and Belgium.
Mestad. Linskins moving inside. Almond to find her on the far side of the paint. Shot clock down to the final 4. Mestad thinking about a 3 again. Has to take it on the sidestep. Can't bank it in. Serbia only down by 4 and a chance to close the gap here with Dabovic. Brooks, mid-ranger, knocks it down. Serbia within a whisker again.
They brought Linskins in when Serbia had Skoric on the floor. Much better matchup for her. Stankovic. Now they've gone out, they've put Brooks to the five. I'm not sure Linskins has the foot speed to get back to Yelena Brooks on her pick and pop action, and she's not able to switch the ball screens the way some of the other Belgians can. So the question is, are they going to do something different defensively there, or do they take Linskins out of the game?
Belgium 53, Serbia 51, with just under 7 minutes to play to decide top spot in Group D. This is a great preparation as well for the latter stages of the competition for two teams that are expected to be there as well. It's got that big game feel about it, blow after blow, momentum shift after momentum shift. And this will really help warm these two up. We know they're both going to advance, but it's about who goes through in pole position.
It's got a knockout game feel to it, even though, you know, both teams are free, through a freebie, really. But a day off, that extra bit of rest, one less game that you could potentially get knocked out at. It's an important game for both teams.
Serbia have threatened so many times to complete the comeback, and Belgium have always found a way to hold them off. Can they continue to do so? Helmond. Messerman gets free off the screen to try and shoot the three. Misses it though, and that's contact to the face from Servan Dakic.
She got a shot in the eye, and that always difficult to come back from. It's in her eye. She may have to go out here for a little while.
Emma Messerman, who leads all scorers on the court with 16 points.
It's going to help Belgium. They've gone to replay this as it gives her some time to get a break. I don't think there's anything in it, but she just got poked in the eye.
Okay.
This is the one player they would not want to lose. A two-time Women's EuroLeague winner. Final Four MVP at the 2018 competition, named to the All-Star Five at both the 2017 EuroBasket and the 2018 World Cup. She is their standout superstar. She's in a spot of bother right now.
This is not going to go down well in this crowd.
Unsportsmanlike foul. And listen to the reaction from the Serbian fans in Zrenjanin.
It's because it was contact with her face. It's an unsportsmanlike foul, but...
it's that left hand of Dabović that catches the face of Messerman. She will have foul shots, and then Belgium will have possession as well.
And it's the fourth foul on Anna Dabović as well. So a big call all round. I mean, the foul was always going to happen, irrelevant of it being unsportsmanlike. But
one of Serbia's stars now walking the disciplinary tightrope. Messerman is cool and composed as you like from the line.
It's really impressive. Messerman, one-eyed, standing up, knocking it down.
6 of 6 from this strike ball together, as well as 6 of 10 from the field for 18 points for Messerman. She surpassed the 20-point mark in both of the previous games. Mestak. Rammer back into Mestak. Finds Messerman to shoot the three at the end of the shot clock. Misses that one. And Servan Dakic the rebound. Serbia looking to come back strong, and a denial from Messerman. Milic making her move, Messerman in the way, doing a bit of everything.
Yeah, really good again for Milic, getting down the floor, but Messerman just timed it perfectly. Look, she was up before Milic knew what she was going to do.
Messerman adds a block to her impressive stat line. 18 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists, a block and a steal. Mestak. We're going to work with Messerman on the far side. Mestak gives it back to Messerman. Quickly closed out by Servan Dakic. She'll try and battle her way through traffic, and a foul called on Servan Dakic. third on Serbia in the fourth quarter. Belgium yet to pick one up, and Messemann a chance to hit 20 again.
Once again, when they need a Messemann there for Belgium, leading the charge. That's a really impressive performance. You see the cut in her eye as well. And you saw the eyelid.
Seven of seven from the foul line in the game. Misses that one. Only a second miss from the line in the tournament. Belgium by five, with just over 5.5 minutes to play. And they pick up their first foul. It's on Raman, her third. Nobody for Belgium on four yet. Samuel Petrovic putting the ball down the floor, serving Dakic. Wants to take on Mestak. Into the lane, looking for the open options on the perimeter. Almond closing out, down the baseline, battling away to the basket, goes Jovanović. Mester, Almond. Almond across to the far side to Raman, she takes it on the dribble drive all the way to the hoop. All the way with her was Serban Dakic.
Yeah, the kick out to Messemann. Not sure why she didn't pass out.
Serbia with a bit between their teeth again. Into Brooks. Left hand finger roll layup will fall. And Serbia are breathing down the necks of Belgium again.
Filip Mester would love to call a timeout right here. Right this crowd, but can't.
13 for Brooks now. Belgium hearing the whistles and the jeers from this partisan Serbian crowd. Mestak with the floater from the foul line misses, and Serbia a chance to get ahead. The hosts riding a wave of momentum. To the far side it goes, Petrovic. It's going to be a long two. Serbia lead from 10 down. The home fans raising the roof for the hosts.
Didn't want to call it, but a Mestak, but he's got no choice whatsoever. Beautiful off-ball movement from Sonja Petrovic, a great pass from Jovanović to know where she was going and to find her. And it wasn't a three, but it might as well have been. Finally, you know, a couple of shots on the outside. Oh, what a final few minutes this is going to be.
Sonja Petrovic was only 3 of 10 from the field before that one. She's up to 8 points, 6 rebounds and 3 steals. And Serbia are finally ahead. Coach Malkovic's team had a 2-point lead way back in the first quarter. That is their largest lead of the game.
Yet, but this game's been close throughout. Belgium had that 10-point lead at one stage, but it's always been right there. Belgium have been the ones in the ascendancy, but Serbia, we talked about it at half, like they'd rested Petrovic, they'd rested Dabrovic for a long time. They're always going to come back in the second half.
What a final 4 minutes we are set up for here in Zrenjanin in Group D. Looking to get their noses back in front. Rana. That opens up. Mestak wants it on the perimeter. Gets it and escapes the attention of the defense to unload and banks it in with the foul. A chance at a 4-point play for Belgium.
Incredible. I was watching Filip Mestak and Belgium completely ran the play. Absolutely wrong. He was over on the sideline, his head in his hands, as they were looking around, not knowing what to do. So whatever he drew up, it was nothing to do with what they ran, but still, Kim Mestak steps up and gets a 4-point play. Incredible.
A moment of Mestak magic to get Belgium ahead by three. Petrovic crosses over into the lane, nice footwork as well through traffic, and she lands a big blow with the contact along the way, and the superstars are trading blows down the stretch.
That's just special from Sonia Petrovic, so easy, just glides past her defender and the help. And you can look at the Belgium help defence, and there was a lot of people in the lane. Surely they should have rotated earlier.
Nothing to separate these two over the first 36 and a bit minutes. 60-60. Those numbers from the line could prove pivotal when it's all said and done. Mestak denied as she went up against Brooks. And second block for Yelena Brooks.
You see, Brooks on the weak side, a lot more ready than the Belgian team was last time.
Messerman. Raman hands it off to Elmont. Raman driving in down the lane, lays it up and in, a big play.
It's a couple of times they've gone to Raman off the drive. Not really sure, you know, down the stretch of a game like this. That's necessarily their best tactic, but she came up with the points there.
She had a couple of big performances in the preparation games. Petrovic misses that one, grabs her own rebound and then gets fouled.
You've got to clean up the boards there, Belgium. Petrovic, you know, misses the tough finish, and now you're going to get it to the line.
Sonia Petrovic hadn't got to the line until that three-point play a few moments ago.
And this is a tough call for Philip Mestag, because Linskins has really struggled. Raman has been like the smaller big for them. And I was thinking, you know, it's a tough ask on Anne Wouters, because she's probably going to have to guard, you know, either Yelena Brooks or Milic. Milic is probably a better matchup for her, so they can afford to bring her in, but she also is a bit big to be guarding this perimeter-based attack of Serbia.
Raman fouls out with only 2 points, but four rebounds, two assists, two steals and a block. She certainly played her part. And certainly playing her part now is Petrovic, who gets Serbia back level again into the final 3 minutes. Now more. Martis setting the screen, moving inside, opens up space on the perimeter. Delar misses the three. Rebound wrestled down for Serbia by Servan Dakic. Now to get ahead again. 2.5 to play. Davovic, their top scorer and top facilitator, en route to gold in 2015. Petrovic, their hero on night one. The superstar of that gold medal campaign as well. Messerman has been a superstar here. Grabs the rebound, gives it to Elmont. Mestak far side, back to Elmont. Messerman on the perimeter. Delar steps back to take on the outside shot, and it's way off from Delar.
It's not the shot that had Messerman. You know, Delar needs to understand. Slicing to the ring, being aggressive, yes. Oh, giving it to Messerman.
Behind the back goes Brooks. Difficult shot, though, contested all the way by Messerman.
But be careful of Mestag in transition here.
Elmont, far side. Mestag trying to get free on the perimeter, received it from Messerman. Gives it back to her. Messerman takes the long two and hits it.
Huge
Messerman, magical again here this evening, now has 21. Damovic dancing through the defence and scoring in traffic with the contact. Serbia just keep on coming back at Belgium.
Belgium had a foul to give, they could have stopped her out here. Instead they let her get into the lane, and you know, Damovic is the master of being able to draw fouls on her way to the ring.
Dabovic now with 11 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists and a steal. She's very quickly found her feet at this tournament after a difficult season in which she had plenty of time off. And she's going to have to wait to take the Zan Won. 66 seconds remaining, Serbia by 2, with a chance to add one more from the strike.
There's a leak in the ceiling. This is work. This is helping Belgium though, because Emma Messman was gasping for breath lining up for these free throws.
And they have to make sure that the floor is safe. And there you can see it. Surely going to have to be patched up before we can continue. Unless we want to put a bucket under the bucket. Now this one has been fantastic. For the opening 39 minutes, 64-64.
Just adds to the tension.
It does indeed.
Minutes ago, we're going to have a stoppage in the game.
They have identified where the leak is coming from. Now it's just a case of stopping it. Belgium have led by as many as 10 points. Serbia have overturned that deficit and momentarily got themselves up, but only by one. And now we're neck and neck, 64-64. Belgium led by the 21 points of Emma Messerman, who's surpassed 20 in every game so far. She's also got 8 rebounds, 4 assists, a steal and a block to lead 3 Belgian players in double figures. Kim Mostak has 15. And Tania Delar has 12. And Serbia led by the 13 apiece of Petrovic and Brooks. They've also had 11 apiece from Dabovic and Jovanovic. So 4 in double digits for Serbia. And after 39 minutes of play, we're still no closer to guessing who will finish top and go directly to the quarterfinals, and who will go instead to the quarterfinal qualifying round. It's a moment of delay to allow the two teams to contemplate how to deal with the final 66 seconds. It's also a moment, I suppose, Lloyd, for us to contemplate what we've seen on this court over the course of the 4 days, and which one of these teams looks better equipped to you to go further in the competition.
It's a really tough question. I think it comes down to the matchups they're going to get coming out against the other groups. What we do know is, you know, these two teams especially, they have the potential to go deep into the competition, but I think, you know, the right matchups for them are going to be important. Absolutely. And to be honest, I don't know what we have learned coming out of this group. We knew going in it was going to be incredibly difficult. I think the fact that every game has been so close means that you haven't allowed these teams to really get a rhythm in the way they might against some other teams, you know, of a lesser ability. So is that going to be good or bad for these two going forward? I'm not really sure. The cut on there, Emma Messman's eye. I mean, she's found her rhythm, that's for sure. A couple of really, really good performances. Not sure what they're going to do about this leak.
The Eurobasket 2 years ago was the first ever podium finish at any major tournament for Belgium. They beat Italy in the quarterfinals, lost to eventual champion Spain in the semis, but responded with a resounding win over Greece in that third-place game. They finished with a 5-1 overall record. And this young team is looking to continue to gel and improve together and to go a step or two further in this competition. Serbia, who won gold at Eurobasket 2015, the previous edition, when they beat France in the final. That was their first ever medal at the Eurobasket. 2 years before, they'd lost the bronze medal match to Turkey, but last time out, in 2017, they failed to even reach the quarterfinals. They lost to Latvia in the previous round. And now, once again, under the stewardship of coach Marina Malkovic, they're hoping to get back to their best, and they've certainly shown signs of being able to do that. And Belgium have certainly shown signs that they can finish on the podium again as well. After that Eurobasket win 4 years ago, Serbia claimed bronze at their very first Olympics as well, in Rio 2016, but that's it in terms of medals for them. They failed to qualify for last year's World Cup and only finished 11th overall in that next edition of this competition. Belgium's ascendancy in the women's game has been remarkable. They failed to qualify for four straight tournaments at the Eurobasket before winning that bronze 2 years ago. They finished fourth at their first ever World Cup last year as well, and they lost to the champions, the USA, in the semis and to Spain in the bronze medal game.
Just trying to figure out how this is going to end. Everyone's looking at the ceiling. There is a gangway up there that you can walk on. I'm surprised that no one's actually been up there, seeing if they can catch the water or stop the leak up higher, because it is very close to the, where you can walk in the ceiling here. You just see it there above Gaggio's head. Anamestag's enjoying her time, though. Dancing away. But yeah, it doesn't appear to be anyone up there yet. And now they're just waiting for the drips to stop and the towel on the floor.
It does seem odd that nobody's gone up there. We've seen the images of exactly where it's coming from. What a long delay for these players to deal with so little of the game to go.
It's incredibly difficult, you know. You come out of this and you're going to need to make a shot at a crucial time, and you've stood around. You've lost your focus, you've lost everything.
And we're dead level as well, so we're basically going to play a 66-second game.
Or plus 5 minutes.
Probably.
Yeah. I mean, you wouldn't be surprised, would you, if it went scoreless in this final 66 seconds.
We haven't had an overtime yet in this group.
And we've got very close.
Sonja Petrovic with a game winner with 1.9 seconds to play in game one. That's as close as we've got. Certainly not, pardon the pun, dampening the spirits in this arena. These fans are getting their money's worth, and they have done throughout the course of the last 4 days. Really enjoying the occasion. Sure, that technical issue, more a plumbing issue.
We haven't had a lot of rain here in Serbia, a lot of sunshine, so hopefully the rain just stops and that's it, we're good to go.
It has been scorching over the last 4 days, as high as 33 degrees Celsius. Too far shy of 100 degrees Fahrenheit into the mid to late 90s, and here we go. Looks as though we are ready to play.
I'm not going to warm them up or anything. Well, this is it.
Anna Dabovic at the stripe, I'd forgotten about that.
I was just about to say exactly the same thing. I forgot she was shooting a free throw. Yeah.
Looking to complete a three-point play that would give Serbia the lead with 66 seconds to play here.
still dripping.
Dabovic misses, and there's a foul, battling for the rebound. It's Wouters.
Two shots.
Belgium at the foul limit. Nikolina Milic next up.
Wow, what an opportunity missed for Serbia.
They're only 14 of 22 at the line. And Belgium are 13 of 15. In such a tight game, it could come down to free throw shooting accuracy. Milic gets the second, Serbia ahead by just one.
Tavovic out for defence and because of those fouls.
Dabovic on four fouls. Raman is fouled out for Belgium. Nobody else on more than three for them, and a foul as it goes in as they tried to force the turnover.
It was nearly a turnover, then it was nearly a layup at the other end, because if Alamon wasn't fouled, she was gone. And she would have been at the other end before anyone could catch her.
Third personal on Servan Dakic. Both teams at the limit. Dabovic will come back in on four fouls. Almon goes to the line to try and give Belgium the lead. Only 2 points for Julie Almon here tonight. It's her first trip to the line.
She's a really good point guard, Julie Almon. If she can add score and if she can add that outside shot, she's going to be, you know, still really young. She can do that. She's going to be one of the best in the world.
22. She had 8 assists a game at the World Cup last year, and she equaled the competition record with 13 in the quarterfinals against France.
Just to clear out Petrovic play. Okay.
Milic puts it up just inside the stripe. Brooks wrestles down the rebound and gets fouled.
Now jump ball possession Serbia. It's the same play they ran for Petrovic to get the game winner the other day. Just clear out a side, let her go one-on-one. Kim Mestag with a really, really good individual defensive play there. And Messman, aware to it, came across and helped.
We're going to have another stoppage, this time for a timeout. 66-65, Belgium, with 49 and a half seconds remaining. But Serbia have the ball. The plumber's arrived. You can see just to the left of your picture who is doing the cleaning up.
49 seconds to go. Serbia. The question is who they give the ball to, Petrovic or Dabovic, to make the play. I think Dabovic will get herself to the line, that's for sure. But Petrovic really is the go-to if you're looking for points with a field goal. And then for Belgium, they'll have had the opportunity to draw something up for their offensive end as well. So both teams able to use this. They've both got a timeout left as well after this one. So still a lot to play for, still a long time left.
Four players scoring in double digits for Serbia. They are all on the floor.
Be careful of Dabovic ducking straight into post up when she enters it.
Here's one of them, Jovanović. Into the paint, back out to Petrovic. Petrovic crosses over, goes down the lane and attacks Messerman, but misses the layup.
Well, can surely go to Messerman here.
Oh, a turnover. Almon not happy with the call.
She's convinced. She's convinced it's her ball.
And they will go to the video to make absolutely sure.
No problem. No problem. And sift my angle.
Just 32.3 seconds to play. Ooh.
Did she touch it with a hand right at the end? Feet, it's clearly off her foot.
Feet first and then hand, this left.
No.
It's just the movement she makes towards it. No.
Here.
It's better, this one.
You can't tell from that angle, surely, because the hand is behind the ball.
I don't think she does touch it. But again, the question is that they called Serbia's possession.
Wait.
So you've got to be convinced that it's not.
Well, there has to be conclusive evidence to reverse the call. Let's find out.
That's good.
Belgian ball.
Really good work for them to, you know, get this right, though. This is why the TV replays are there, so we don't get that, those sort of mistakes.
66-65 Belgium, 32 seconds to play. Top spot in Group D, hanging in the balance. Almond, we're going to work with Messerman, who sets the screen. Almond on the burst, taking the ring road around the defence. Messerman steps back behind the three-point line, attacks in the paint, floats one off the window, wouldn't go down though. Shot clock turned off, and here come the hosts. Into the lane, Dabovic, a foul on the floor. But they are at the limit, so Dabovic will go to the line with 11.3 seconds to play.
She put on the line. She made them make up the free throws. They've still got 11 seconds to get a score of their own. They've got a timeout left. I'm not sure if it's the best call, but I don't think it's the worst either for Belgium.
Dabovic, one of two from the stripe.
Usually she's so good at the line in these crunch situations.
Gets the first to tie. Several thousand on their feet in Zrenjanin. Now for the lead. The hosts ahead. Anna Dabovic doing the business.
A long time for an offense, so. And I've got to say that Filip Mesdag has been really good with his sets, with drawing stuff up through this group. You know, they've executed really well. He's got some good weapons. He has some really nice plays that he can call on. I think he'll draw something up to get him a good clean look here. Question is whether they're going to make it.
11.3 seconds left on the clock. Belgium down by 166-67. Whoever wins this one finishes top and advances straight to the quarterfinals. The loser goes into the quarterfinal qualifier round. And that game would take place in Belgrade on Tuesday. The quarterfinals are in Belgrade on Thursday. It's got to be Messerman or Mesdag, surely.
Yeah, it has to be. It has to be a touch for Messerman. With the threat of Kim Mesdag close to her, that if they try to help, Mesdag can take the open three.
Messerman on 21 points, 7 of 13 from the field. Mesdag on 15 points, 5 of 12. Delar will inbound.
So be careful here, Mesdag in the far corner.
11.3 left. For Belgium to try and win the game and to finish top, and a steal! And she'll try and cling on to it, Jovanovic. Belgium desperately trying to foul. The precious seconds are ticking away. The fans are on their feet, and this place is rocking.
What a play from Jovanovic. What a defensive play.
The birthday girl might just have won it. It's going to be Petrovic at the line with only 1.8 seconds left. And this is the first.
Either way, a three wins it, so yeah. It's almost irrelevant. It's a rebound and a heave.
misses both.
So the clock should get put back to 1.8. They're going to change the clock.
We are not done and dusted just yet. 10:30 local time in Zrenjanin, Serbia. And it's been long, but it's been exhilarating every step of the way.
So there you go, 1.8 on the clock, the same way it was on the free throws. That's a lot of time.
Any score to win it for Belgium here. Now or never for them. Delard gets it in, they can't handle it. And Serbia finish searing hot from centre court. 3-0 in the group stage as they build steam towards Belgrade for the quarterfinals. And they win the group in emphatic fashion. The first time they've ever won all three games at this stage.
When you needed a player from Serbia stepped up, didn't they? Either the offensive end or the defensive end. Just that execution in those final few moments. Congratulations to Serbia.
What a fantastic way to finish the group, and what a group it has been. All of the games so competitive and so close. The group of death got rid of Belarus, but Belgium, Serbia and Russia march on. Serbia as group winners as they beat Belgium 70-66.
Oh, what an incredible game. All the way through. I know we had the double-digit lead at one point, but, you know, nothing in it throughout. Belgium will be frustrated because they played so well in that first half to let the lead slip. But I think they're going to take credit from this. I wouldn't be surprised to see these two teams facing off again at a later date in this competition, that's for sure.
There you see the numbers, very little to choose between the two. Serbia survived that poor free throw shooting percentage to win a tight game down the stretch. They grabbed 9 more offensive rebounds, and that was key for them as they put up 6 more field goal attempts. And had one fewer turnover as well. 4 players scoring in double digits for the hosts, led by the 16 of Yelena Brooks in the end. She also had 5 rebounds, a couple of assists, a steal and 2 blocks. They had 13 apiece from Petrovic and Dabovic, and 11 from Jovanovic. Messerman leading Belgium with 21 points and 9 rebounds, 4 assists for Amon. Dabovic had 5 assists on her stat line for Serbia. Both of these teams will go on. Belgium have one more game to play before they can be in the final 8. Serbia are there already and have a good rest before that quarter-final on Thursday. And what a way to say goodbye to these fans here in Zrenjanin as both of these teams move on to the capital. It's been a pleasure having your company in Zrenjanin for Group D. Attention turning to Belgrade now for the knockout rounds here at Women's Eurobasket 2019.